This place was dead on Main Street before we started opening the doors and really, you know, making it a community center for people, I think.
Cobleigh Public Library.
You're in an area right now that's in the 3-county poorest area in the state of Vermont. You know, we're hemorrhaging jobs.
Yeah.
We're hemorrhaging income. And Pat's finding a way of reaching out to people and say there's resources. This is when government works its best.
The library isn't a private institution. You know, it's a public institution. It's supported by the town, so that everybody in the town ought to have access to it. One of our focuses is a community center. Because we're in Lyndonville, where there is no community center as such, you know, there's no... I mean, I get calls saying, you know, where's your internet cafe? It's right here. You know? And that means all of the organizations and groups that form in the town for whatever reason. The Historical Society, you know, doesn't have its own building, so it meets here. The Girl Scouts, they don't have a building. The Boy Scouts, the Chamber of Commerce, you know, there's an alternative school starting, and they don't really have a facility yet. So we're kind of helping with Freeman Money. I've hired somebody to help with teens to work with them. Now they have a space, but they don't have computers, so they tutor here. The school district sometimes needs a space that's away from the school environment.
This is when government reaches out to people and says, we have services that you don't know that you need, but we're going to offer you. When people say, you're right, you know what? That bookmobile's made a difference.
I mean, the first bus was bought with a school district monies, but we used it.
One of the resources that they're tapping into that you might find interesting is homeschoolers are coming and using the library. And that, of course, there's been a 600% increase in homeschooling in the state.
Really? Over what period?
Over, I believe, the last 8 years.
The library needs to respond to the community. What does the community want? If the community needs internet access in town and there's no place else, then we ought to provide it. I think there would be people who would take issue. We answered the phone for the Chamber of Commerce. Take issue with that. That's certainly not a traditional library service.
No.
But it is information. And I found that the way this happened was I found that I'm answering all these questions anyway about, you know, what's going on in the community, where are things located, you know, all of those things are information questions. So why not just answer the phone for them and do it? So that's what we do. And as a result of that, we get a little bit of money from the Chamber of Commerce.
In my department, which is the history department, we work with the Town Historical Society. My students presented at the State Historical Fair in June. Pat and the Historical Society requested their presentation to be shown at the library. My daughter has grown up in her reading program, as has my son. And what we've got is lifetime readers out of this.
Okay, everybody over. This won't take long, but we want you all to get honored. Come.
I was asked the kids, who do these books belong to? You know, and they always say, you, you know, and point to me. No, they're yours, you know. Come and use them. These are the welcome baby bags that we give out through our Pack Rat committee as a part of Success by Six. We get the names of all those born from town clerk's offices where they're registered. We always suggest Goodnight Moon as a very first read to. We have this little set of books for the siblings, so that a sibling will get something out of the deal too. And then there's a resource kit, which includes information about area agencies. They can come in and dedicate a book to their child, and that's really pretty nice because they come in years later and find their book. You know, information about Dr. Dinosaur, which is a health program, there's a ton of information out there. So they come in and they get a letter saying after their baby's born saying you can come and pick up the bag at the library or we'll deliver it to you. Second year they get the Born to Read t-shirt. So it works pretty well. This is their library, they're taxpayers in town, their families are taxpayers in town. You know, it's kind of like putting the handprints on the bus. This is yours, not mine, or, you know, Emily's or Janice's. Right, this belongs to you now.
It's pretty nifty. We are really excited, and so is this town, about having this. It's been wonderful.
Yeah.
And believe me, I didn't do this by myself. It took a whole village.
Yes.